Okay, we have everyone counting us in at various speeds here. Welcome people at home. This is the series finale of IWC. Will Rawl ever find true love? You know, I don't know. We got canceled in our best season. So aliens in the future, if you're watching this, resurrect me, please. I hate being dead. I've been dead for so long. I'm going to do my best Jessica impression here and read you a quotation because she says she sounds like a dude. Is that what you said? She's losing her voice. I think she said, I sound like a dude. You said that to me. Yeah. No, I wasn't just insultingly making that up. Okay, here we go. Look for your miracles. Hope for the best. But when you can't change what you're going through, let the simple, quiet, daily miracle of acceptance find you. How's that? Was that a Jessica? That was Jessica Cole impersonating Jessica reading Melody Beattie. This is the Inspired Word Cafe. Welcome. Welcome. Woo! Yes. Okay. Okay, last show. So here's what we're going to do. Everyone from IWC that showed up is going to read some stuff. Rawl's going to do a little bit of a goodbye. Then it's going to like flash and the whole thing is going to have been a dream and you'll wake up and you know, JR never got shot and everything and they're in the shower and he finally caught the bear. Okay. So we're off to a good start. All right. So without further ado, we're going to bring up the captain of the ship himself. Rawl Imajames. Is that how you say that? Okay.
Spot on.
Thank you.
I must have grown, so. It's really cool to be back on mic at the IWC taping, the last taping. It's kind of a good way to go out. We kind of came in the first show thinking we were just rehearsing, and Greg goes, okay, that's a wrap, and same thing tonight. So I'm going to just recite some poems that I wrote recently and call it a day, and then I'll say whatever comes to mind. So this is a piece I wrote just recently. I wrote a piece in honor of the tragically hip and Gord Downie, who just passed a few months back. I was asked to do a piece at the tribute concert that happened right here in Kelowna, so enjoy. I wipe away tears to see the constellation reveal your star as I pen words with timeless ink. My heart's pounding, hoping to capture a small glimpse of the poet in the long grass. Beyond all of our future moments, your artful walk united this country with song and poetry under the morning moon. Six flames band to blush against the moonlight serenade of our hearts as it thumped with the joy to the magic that's the hip. Souls uplifted to spirit beyond the stars in a dance between sun rays looking for hope and possibility. Transcendent notes and words take shape in a moment of suspended time to allow the light to shine in its splendor. Inspired words spoken as a festive gift to your life. Your love served as a gentle kiss upon our lips as we immersed in rippled waters that calmed a troubled mind. Together, we rejoice from the choice made repeatedly to listen. And in my case, singing really, really badly, but with such joy. A moment of divine tranquility, venturing to new heights into the unknown of a new song, for we just trusted because it came from the hip. It's been a long time running, tangling the grace from the smoky bars at Queen Street to my final sing-along with tears streaming down my face. Love sight to fuel the fury, hearts battered from the shine in our moments of unity. Together we are ballads of found souls rejoicing with the snare and bass of another riff that make our feet dance away our sour notes of life as we refuse to give in to conformity. And as our spirit, and as your spirit flies with the raven to usher in another tomorrow, epic tale serenades our soul from sonnets written to heal the longing. We all claim witness to your saga in your final days as we all wished a wish for a final glance or a last touch that just etched lasting echoes of your voice. My memory's murky from days gone by, but your love flows in all the waters as a reminder to embrace the now, as our souls two steps to the rhythm and our hearts greedily eat up your words. No exit stage right on a broken leg of chance. Your legacy goes beyond song and poetry. They will stand timeless like the ink that pens these words to describe your infinite flow that touched so many. Harmony calms the beast in us all as the memory haunts the mystic soundtrack of our Canadian experience. Let's swear that we will get with the times and that we got the friendship right, Gordon. You lived it day by day and you lived it well. You are now off to the next adventure where you are needed, for we best grow when we are needed. Thank you. No, that's a piece I like. I wrote that, like I said, I'm a huge hip fan. I go way back. I still remember my buddy after a rugby game dragging me out. Like, this is in like late 80s, maybe 88. So you gotta come out, man. We're gonna go listen to this band. And I'm like, dude, I don't really wanna watch a bunch of white boys rock out. But we went. I'm glad I did, because that was the first time I heard the hip. So it was really cool. This next piece, I don't know. It's like one of my favorites. But that's like saying, you know, which child is your favorite? Just don't tell the other poems you're my favorite. So again, no name. She is patient with time and expects nothing, for she knows nothing happens without a choice and in the right time. She simply holds space to offer a hand for when I fall, or a shoulder for tears to waterfall. She cloaked my inner child with her unwavering spirit, but my foolish pride had me trapped in the fog of insensitivity that just for a moment allowed her beauty to be absent. For only in the constant echoing of doubt did I question her resolve. For you see, her beauty is her strength, and her strength is beauty. And as I stood at the threshold, hesitating at the roads that laid before, feeling alone and abandoned, I am conflicted by which path to take. I look for courage void of fear as I search high and low for the strength of character that lingered in the chasm of right and left brain thinking, hoping that my choice this time would remove the rose-colored glasses that flooded me with ego's lust for balance between ignorance and blinded intelligence. She is the unspoken whisper that floats upon the trade winds. The subtle, shy slant of her eyes, seductively inspired hints of untamed playfulness. The slight tilt of her head highlights her flowing braided hair, and the way it partially covers her caressing moon smile. For reasons beyond my understanding, her beauty shined like never before. And as I trembled at the doorway of discomfort, she gently took my hand and placed it upon her heart. And without uttering a word, she reminded me of the flame that burns within. In that moment, her strength was her beauty. For her beauty transcended the moment and appeared as a multitude of orchestrated thoughts. Once again, I embraced her beauty to silence my own will. I accepted her feminine wiles, which unfolded beneath my feet as solid ground. And if I had the audacity to breathe in the particles of her beauty. My lungs will forever be filled, my thirst forever quenched. She invited me into my own vulnerability to see the strength of my own beauty. And as our souls frolicked and pranced in the garden of content, our bodies floated on beds of water lilies on a river of her tears with only imagination as our guide. She once again reminded me that alone is a construct designed to blind self. And as the day's light crept closer to revealing the night secrets, I safely cocooned my soul into her beauty to dream dreams of shooting stars that lit up our soul's playground. And as we fell with the sands of time, witnessing time itself stand still, we are reborn into our wild and free self to dance for the sake of the dance, succulently under the stars by the light of the pale moon. For you see, her beauty is her strength, and her strength is beauty.
Okay, that was Raw. I'm here now. Yeah, woo! This poem's called Stillness and the Amount of Hope You Need to Grieve. When she pulled the trowel out of the spring dirt, she saw two halves of a bee. Life traded for space for bulbs bought at Walmart. She had a hard time being sad, though. Admittedly, selfishly, her well was dry. The place in the soil was so fast to find her, caught her brimming last week with indifference towards the imperative, as in email, the tide knocking each time, or giving in and going to a movie. She allowed, like folk monsters and the rest of the world, she was somewhat under the amount of hope one needed to grieve. The halves of the bee squirmed. It did not make wax. It had nothing to offer but its own contusion, so waking up dying, it went still. Again, in the crosswind, a monarch's reign ends for blue dahlias. She'd read somewhere recently they were changing the length of a second, that the Earth had drifted too far away from the orbit of the sun for even the clocks to stay the same. She shrugged off the backyard death, her eyes still in control in the sting of the water table, keep digging for a second before again checking the time on her phone as an excuse for really looking for something from her father. It was 3:30. He had found the flashlight app this week was looking really old these days already. She could feel time was coming. She had slept beside the big hugging river. She had watered the candle. And now this. They lived under the ground, the bees, and she never knew until the library seminar with the Neapolitan concrete carpet that almost all of them built homes beneath bird baths and roots and drive-in theaters. Pesticides weren't killing them, necessarily. Suburbs were. She didn't like movies, really, but out of the two soon-to-be fads, superheroes and the post-apocalypse, she preferred superheroes. Fiction or not, they had hope still. At least they were still hoping. They were, at least, still trying. She preferred cartoons that had a field of lavender at the end and the fountain clanking of Sozu ambiance, but she wasn't sure our old white dude of a language had the capacity to warn people anymore, or hope, or do anything but destroy. The apocalypse at all seemed silly to her, as if the end of such a small example of scope around a big star mattered enough to get a title. Just about everything is orbiting something somewhere, and so arrogant, she thought, to assume humans make it past the apocalypse. Lets people romanticize giving in, pretend an after exists. Her phone buzzed. Dad, who had recently taken to texting flagrant emojis and chopping of letters from the smallest of words, had woken up on the couch. She smiled, and then, looking back down, didn't. There was still this. She wanted to bury the bee, but digging graves begets digging graves, and she was worried she might never stop. She thought of the archived letter she'd read before grad school, said something like, "There's just got to be a slow way out of all I'm in just now." Her whole life, she had walked on the roofs of pollinators, and her fellow humans raced to take away all of the places they could live for flower plots and cherry blossoms, for child samurai fights in front of fish tanks and malls named after the bones of the orchards they built the foundations on. She wasn't sure she had what it took to learn to float. As in, not quite pedal, but above sea level, the imperative for never disturbing the earth again. Never touch the dirt with her feet. She set down the trowel, breathed in the mirage heat, felt the waves of a 10-year-old version of herself's old midnight sprinkler race Roman candle fight with brothers, cousins, her father, drinking, laughing, robust, still waiting for the ocean to take back all of the earth in front of it. Waiting to return the gas lamp to the dark beneath the puddle by the sprinkler in the garden. How long was that? Okay, I'll just do one more then. Okay, this is a short one. This poem's called Asking the Spoon to Run Away Takes Courage. A spoon's work is never done. It sits folded into time, waiting, as we all do, to be picked up. It has become the kind of action, using a spoon, where when you, your fingers, are cold enough, a debt is extracted from the sink. It must be paid in full in that action movie kind of way, crawling through glass or reaching inside the wall as if seeing for the millionth time this week if you could fit. Tomorrow, they will need you to scoop, and all the world is required present to make certain the passive voice completing of this task is done with the fervent complacency needed to end up back in the drawer where you belong. Thank you.
This one is called Glass Webs. Your words are glass webs, bad music, birthday bumps on a cold day. They blanket synapses, fall into hot springs, upset my mother. You gut trout with your bare hands. Find me singing against the wall, beanstalk in my belly. Too fast around the hairpin. Thank you.
I can't believe this is the end. I'm sad. And I'm losing my voice, so I'm going to try my best to read without screeching too much. Okay. This poem I actually did name, and it's called Distant Island. He was a rock, a distant island, dependable yet deserted. She was the ocean itself, turbulent yet serene. Wishing tides would turn, she looked to the full moon, reaching for his shoreline. Gravital forces pushes for the right time, where the stars align, created by divine, cycles of grand design. His cliff faces, she attempts to climb. Gravital pulls amplify, and the crashing waves intensify. She cannot oversimplify. She would never leave him high and dry. Okay.
Voice sounds great.
I think I do sound kind of like a man today, but that's okay.
Oh,
okay. Sexy man. Okay, here's my other one, and there's no title to this one. There's no expectation. It's not black and white. You entered my life with the brightest of light. You saw through my eyes, spoke the language of heart. You held up the mirror when I was falling apart. Reflecting divine truth, kindness and peace. Your presence is a gift, puts anxiety at ease. I've released all the stories of what this might mean, to bask in the moment, to just let it be. This friendship a gift, uplifting me higher, to teach and to grow, to be re-inspired. What no longer serves me, I've placed it in the fire. Step into unknown lands and trust that I'll transpire. Shed all that's old, stand back in my power, unfolding and growing like a marigold flower. So thank you, dear friends, for reflecting your light. You're like a bright star, lighting the dark parts of my life. The fog it has lifted and the paths become clear, consumed with divine love rather than fear. guided by source, singing my heart song. We're never alone, because in truth, we all belong. Rooted and grounded, earth beneath feet. Rediscover my rhythm as I dance to its beat. And when I forget the words, you sing them back to me. Thank you for your friendship, for being part of my journey. Here's a poem about mental health and well-being. Split. He was split between worlds, but no one could see. The way that he suffered, he was starving for peace. Along came a girl who saw past his flaws. She then built a fire to melt down his walls. Gently but firmly, she reached for his hand, searching lost cities that lived in the man. She discovered ancient ruins, a fortress around his heart. She discovered sparks of beauty, inviting a new start. She dug through his rubble, finding bits and parts. Nothing is wasted when you can transform it into art. She painted with love, used patience for glue, creating mosaics from shattered pieces of truth. She placed it in the window as the sun shined through, beautiful colors that illuminate you. She knew she couldn't save him from the monsters in his head, but she could love him there and be a friend instead. She found stars in his darkness, comfort in his light. She didn't fear the beast who hid out of sight. She looked in his eyes to the gentle parts of soul. Remembering to love is to also let go. She believed he could mend, take flight to the sky. She imagined a world where she could walk by his side. She struggled for freedom. He struggled for freedom, so she hoped one day flowers would bloom where there once was decay. And as the paths cross and journeys unwind, nothing is lost. She prays he will find a trustworthy companion whose loyalty will never die, an angel he cherishes, soul, body, and mind. She prays he finds peace, and she prays he breaks through. She prays all his dreams will one day come true. She hopes somewhere deep down, he knows she's sincere, that the love that is felt was stronger than the fear. Thank you.
Okay, hi, my name is Mark Bertolotti. I'm a drummer in a rock and roll band, and I'm a lyrical poet. And this one's for all. This one's called Friends Until the End, and the rest of my friends in the audience. Way to go, bros and sis. You are friend. You're someone who you can trust. Nice to meet you, bud. I swear it was a must. We've been through some hard times, so now we are wiser. We can read the signs, so we should help each other along for the ride, side by side and eye to eye. It'll be good for all of us, because I know you're watching my back and I got yours, like eagles we soar. Even in times of trouble, when we need to make amends, I'm sure we'll knock down the pieces and start over again. Through thick and thin, we never gave in. We never gave up, even when the egos were about to erupt. I'll be there for you when there's no one else. I'll be at your side, beside myself. Doesn't matter what we are going through, nothing can be more true. No matter what's around the next bend, we will always be friends until the end. Thanks, guys, for everything. Okay, this next poem is called Wild Ride, because the last 5 years of my life has been a wild ride on this show. Wild ride, 0 to 100 in a flash. All you can do is pray you don't crash. Behind your weapons with full tanks of gas. You can tell you guys ain't doing this just for the cash. Sometimes you have to wonder why there's more than meets the eye. It's like riding thunder, though sometimes you can't remember nights that have gone on by. All you can remember is you're telling yourself you want to do this till the day you die. Now when you're on your way to where you want to be, you'll be on your way to your destiny. Just keep an open mind and go with their winging it. You'll be sure to find everyone will be singing it. Thanks. This next poem is called State of Mind. You might think you know me and that I care a little too much. You might think I'm lonely, only for your touch. I can't change the way you feel. All I can do is tell you what's real. It was the sound of your voice, the look in your eyes, feelings from my heart that made me realize I've been wrapped up inside for all too long. Sometimes I ask myself if I'm doing something wrong. Maybe it may be just a state of mind, but I think we're two of a kind. So I promise to you I'll never lie. You and I forever in my eyes. Thanks. Okay, this next one's called Deep in Thought, and I've been in deep in thought for a long time, so this is what I came up with, Deep in Thought. Deep in thought I wrought, with all the poverty and homelessness in the world, with all the poetry and loneliness one could have deserved, with all the wars and those government chores, what do we have in our future, what do we have in store? We've all made mistakes in the past, life pushes us hard and fast, though I've never been that far off track, so as you go, now you know, dreams do come true, you just have to do what you do. Thanks. Okay, one more left. This is called In the End, My Friend. Now, I'm not proud of many things I've said and done, though I want you to know I'm not out to prove myself to anyone. I just take my life as it comes, and in the end, my friend, what's done is done. We can't bring back yesterdays, doesn't matter what we do or say. So if we all just live for today, everything would work out in the end, my friend, anyway. Memories we share are beyond compare. What I'm really trying to say to you all is that you've been a fine, fine friend, so remember, wherever you go, I've got your back any day, anytime, anywhere. In the end. Thank you, guys. Thanks. Bye,
everybody. Well, here we are. The last few moments of IWC on Shaw. That's an Inspired Word Cafe for you, Cole. Just wanted to say thank you. You know, it's, I don't say hard to believe, but it's been a good ride for 3 years. And, you know, on behalf of the collective, you know, so I'll ask you guys to come up and we can all wave goodbye to everyone at home. You know Cole and Jessica, and especially you, Jen. I'll miss you the most. And Mark. But no, it's been an honor for us to bring IWC to you at home. You know, it always warmed my heart when we're running around in the streets doing our things, and people go, "Hey, I saw you guys on TV," and you know, people actually watch the show. So that's really cool. And then just to see where poetry has gotten to, the level it's gotten to in this town, it's just so cool to see so many different things going on. So I just wanted to thank our producer, Greg Truman, for taking us under his wing and teaching a bunch of know-it-all poets how to operate a camera and soundboards and how to be technically savvy and put on a show. And you know, to Kirk, when we sat down and pitched the idea, he goes, "Yeah, okay, sure." So it's been a blast. And then to the collective, you know, the last 3 years has been a blast, and especially the last year, just kind of not being involved and watching it on TV. It's really cool watching your own show on TV. But why don't you guys come up? Mark, Greg, you can leave the camera. Come stand up and let's just say goodbye to everyone. And not so goodbye, but so long. We'll see you around town. I think we'll still be playing on replays. But to Arlene and to who's not here? Arlene and
Darren, is that her name?
Darren?
Darren.
Aaron Scott.
Aaron Scott.
That crazy woman that came to me 3 years ago, "So can I be involved in IWC?" And I go, "Sure." And it's been a great, great roller coaster ride ever since then. So these people, sure.
You miss Jen the most?
Give me the mic. See what I got to put up with. But honestly, to you folks at home, without you watching on TV, without coming out to the open mics, without coming out to the slam, we don't get to do this. So we thank you for your support. Continue to support local community television. Continue to support the arts and culture. There's a lot of cool things going on in Kelowna and the Central Okanagan, and we're just happy to be a really small part of it. So, you know, from the bottom of our hearts, it's been a blast for the last 3 years to come into your home and, you know, drop a few, hopefully, intelligent notes that hopefully made you think and
in your homes.
We're in your home. So
dropping notes.
We just want to say thank you very much. We love you. And as signing off, be gentle with yourself so you can be gentle with someone else. Peace.